everyone. I'm Dr. Sneha, your host, welcoming you all in yet another episode of Welcome Wellness with Experts, presented by Trident Communication in association with World Humanitarian Foundation. Today, we are going to talk about gut health and immunity. So let's welcome our expert for today, Bhakti Kapoor. Bhakti, she is a founder of Healthy High. Healthy High is a platform that provides virtual nutrition counseling via video calls from the comfort of your home. Being a strong proponent of holistic well-being, she designs personalized nutrition plans, integrating the science behind the nutrition with food options that are locally and easily available, keeping in mind your feeding preferences all the times. She curates a roadmap for your personal nutrition needs, be it a weight management or treatment of lifestyle diseases, thereby helping you to achieve your health and fitness goals as swiftly and steadily as possible. She assists in tracking your progress and motivating you to eat mindfully, to stay focused and to form long-term healthy habits that will enable you to achieve your healthy high. Do follow her on Instagram, Get Healthy High, and you can log on to www.gethealthyhigh.com. A very warm welcome to Bhakti. How are you doing?
I'm good. Thank you, Sneha. Thank you for the warm, lovely introduction. It's a pleasure and an honor to be here. I mean, this is a lovely initiative by Trident Communication to put out some useful information out there for all their viewers.
Yeah, it's definitely a very wonderful platform for all of us. So, Bhakti, we'll start with the questions. And first, just let us know what inspires you to be in the business as a nutritionist.
Thank you for asking that, Sneha. So, I just wanted to do something to be able to provide to the lives of, you know, people around. I just wanted to contribute something to make them happier and healthier. And what better than, you know, giving them the knowledge of eating the right foods at the right time so that, you know, they can stay at their fittest and healthiest so that they can live life to the fullest. So basically, it just originated from a means to providing to a healthier community. And it is one of the most fulfilling and enriching, jobs. And I have loved every bit of my journey so far.
So that's more important. If you are loving your job, then it makes others also like to fall in love with you.
That's so true. So it is really passion driven for me. And, each day it's just so enriching.
So Bhakti, how can our nutrition, like, it helps us to fight against COVID-19 pandemic? It has been like this last two years for everyone's life. It's quite tough for everyone. So how does this nutrition helps in this pandemic thing?
So nutrition is basically one of the most important pillars of your health. You know, the minute you have your nutrition right, everything else is bound to be right. Now, there are a lot of other factors as well, like your sleep, exercise, you know, hydration, all of those in synergy act beautifully towards a healthier body. So nutrition per se, just avoiding processed foods and eating right on a daily basis, basically getting in your macros, which is your carbohydrate, your protein, your good fat, fiber, is going to lead to a healthier body, basically disease-free and feeling your best, you know, your energy levels. Your body is constantly talking to you. So you have to listen, and if you're eating right, you're bound to feel your best. You know, you're bound to have healthy gut health, basically no acidity, no constipation, no bloating. So when you're eating right, all of this is bound to fall in place and you're going to feel your best and you're going to be able to lead a healthy life. So nutrition really forms a basis of building good immunity and being able to fight this pandemic that we're in.
Yeah, that's true, because nutrition is the fuel for our body actually to work. Right. So Bhakti, can you give us some general nutrition guidance that we all should follow during this pandemic time?
Most definitely. So the general guidelines basically when it comes to nutrition is getting enough protein on a daily basis. Now protein, the good sources of protein comes from for vegetarians would be soy and soy products and milk products. Even lentils, pulses, dals, they're a decent source of protein, but they're not high biological value and not considered a very high source of protein because they still contain 60 to 65% of carbohydrate, which is something that a lot of people are still unaware of, you know. So you need to get in a sufficient protein on a daily basis. For non-vegetarians, it comes from your egg and all your meat products. So it's much easier to get in your required amount of protein there. And again, complex carbohydrates is what you need to really lean towards. Millets are fabulous. Millets like ragi, jawar, nachni, your barnyard millet, and pseudo cereals like quinoa and amaranth, which is your rajgira. These brown rice, oats, they're just fabulous sources of complex carbohydrates, which you know are high in fiber and also have a higher micronutrient profile. So the release of sugars is so much more controlled, which keeps your energy levels much better because your blood sugars are balanced. So opting for these sources of carbohydrates and avoiding refined sources like your maida, white breads, you know, overloading of white rice, all of these are beautiful for the body because excess sugars is what lowers your immunity levels, you know. So stay away from all refined sugars. That is key. And getting in a diversity of vegetables and fruits. So basically, all your low-carb veggies include, you know, all mushrooms, zucchini, your bitter gourd, bottle gourd, just about any low-carb veggies are beautiful sources of antioxidants, fiber, vitamins and minerals, which is something that your body really needs on a daily basis. Also, the good fiber from these is what keeps your gut bacteria healthy, which is what we're here to talk about. You know, your gut health has a very, very important role to play in your immunity and your overall well-being. So really focusing on getting enough vegetables and fruits on a daily basis must be a top priority. And coming to fats, you need to avoid all refined oils, which are basically toxins to the body. In the manufacturing process itself, these refined oils have trans fats that are generated and they cause inflammation within the body. So we should opt for ghee, coconut oil, any cold pressed oil like avocado oil, olive oil, or your mustard oil, groundnut oil. These are all fabulous sources of fat. Again, nuts and seeds are great. So, you know, diversify on those as well. Whatever you enjoy eating, get some seeds on a daily basis. I advocate a seed mix to all my clients, which is, you know, roasting some flax seeds, sesame seeds, watermelon seeds, pumpkin seeds, powdering them and adding them to your meals on a daily basis, which is a great way to get in good fat. So this is what your diet should actually comprise of. A beautiful balance of all macro and micronutrients and just simple home-cooked meals. You need to always have foods that you love eating, you know, because that's when your body is going to gain benefits from it.
Yeah, definitely. That's a very, very wonderful information we got from you. Bhakti, I just want to ask, like you, as you told, we should take protein in a good quantity during this pandemic time. But what are the good sources of protein for a vegetarian person?
Okay, I just mentioned those. So they would be milk and milk products, and they would be soy and soy products like your, you know, tofu, edamame, and paneer, yogurt, or just milk. These are your high biological value protein sources for vegetarians. And also dals, legumes, beans, they're also good sources, but not as high as the ones that I mentioned before.
So what is the role does our gut health play in our immunity?
So our gut basically refers to our intestine. And 70% of your immune system resides in your gut, which is in your intestine. And here there is a major role of good bacteria and bad bacteria. Now, when there is overpowering of good bacteria, that means it's a healthy body. You know, you're going to feel your best in all aspects of your body. And when there is a dysbiosis, means there's overpowering of the bad bacteria, is when your body's going to talk to you by having low energy levels, lethargy, acidity, bloating, constipation. All of these are signs that the bad bacteria has overpowered. So you constantly need to take care of your gut health by sleeping well, exercising on a daily basis, meditating, because your stress levels have a very important role on your gut bacteria. Also, eating the right kind of food. So eating less of refined sugars, processed foods, and eating a diversity of high fiber, antioxidant rich fruits and vegetables is what is going to flourish your good bacteria. Hydrate well on a daily basis. And this has such a beautiful impact, not only on your physical being, but also your mental being, because there is such a strong connection between your brain and your gut. So there's like a mind-brain connection. Mind and gut connection that is connected by the vagus nerve. And we need to constantly keep our gut in the best state so that we feel our best mentally. Health is not just absence of disease, you know, it is feeling your best emotionally, physically, and socially. So gut health has a very, very important role to play in your overall well-being. And like I said, because the immune system resides in the gut, it's extremely important to feed your gut bacteria, you know, with the right foods on a daily basis. And probiotics are basically good bacteria. And you get your probiotics from yogurt, kimchi, sauerkraut, miso paste. So kombucha is a good form again. Having these on a daily basis is like flushing your intestine with good bacteria again. And prebiotics are basically fuel for your good bacteria again. And these come from your onions, leeks, asparagus, garlic. So these feed your good gut bacteria, and that's why prebiotics and probiotics are extremely important for your gut to do its best.
That's very nice information, Bhakti. So we are coming towards the end. Like, there are two more questions to ask, and these two questions are of my personal interest also. So during current lockdown situation, there is a lot of anxiety everyone is facing, and like most of the people are into like emotional eating things. I am one of them. So like, what advice do you give to avoid that emotional eating or stress eating?
That's a wonderful question, Sneha. So it's really important that you know, whenever you want to eat, you ask yourself, there's a technique called HALT. So you ask yourself, am I hungry? Am I just angry? Am I lonely or am I tired? So if the answer, you know, is true to any of the later three, that means you're not really hungry. So you need to constantly be in sync with your mind. Don't ever eat mindlessly, but eat mindfully. You know, listen to your body. So that's very, very important. Also, not keeping junk foods around is the key. You know, surround yourself with healthy food options. Like a lot, like I said, lots of fruits and vegetables. Your snacks would be like hummus with veggie sticks, guac with veggie sticks. Then again, a lot of fresh seasonal fruits, nuts, and homemade cookies. These are the foods that you should snack on. Just avoid any processed foods. And, you know, you're going to be able to do your body the best and keep your health at its best.
Now, yeah, we'll definitely follow these tips. Bhakti, like, you are a mother of two boys, and same with me also. So what healthy habits we should incorporate in our children to maintain their nutrition level, especially in these tough times?
Right. So for the same, what I do is I literally give the power to the boys. So, you know, they get to pick, like, say, for example, if we're doing a pizza, or tonight there's pasta for dinner. So we opt either for a chickpea pasta, or we sometimes do like a whole wheat one. So firstly, a base should never be like a refined, even if it's their rotis, you know, we prefer to go like for the millet rotis or their parathas are with rajgira and stuff. So just opting for healthier grains for kids and then letting them do fun things is fabulous. So I give them the option of picking vegetables. So they have to pick a minimum of 5. So, you know, they feel that the power lies with them, and empowering them is just so beautiful. I don't impose and force them to eat anything so that, you know, they enjoy their meals. They're eating it with a smile, which I feel is very, very important. Again, we do fun-shaped veggie cutlets with them. We don't stock any processed cookies or foods to tempt them. They, like my older one is very fond of baking. So we do stuff at home, and they're just they have healthy options available to them at all times, so that they're not tempted to, you know, hamper their health by eating junk and processed foods. Yeah.
That's very wonderful. And Bhakti, that's all for today's talk. And it was an amazing, amazing feeling to have you with us. And we get so many wonderful tips for it to incorporate in our daily life and to keep ourselves healthy. Thank you very much, Sneha.
Thank you. It was an absolute pleasure to be here, and I have thoroughly enjoyed sharing all this information with you as well. Thank you for having me.
So, our viewers, stay tuned with us for more Welcome Wellness episode coming up every Sunday with Trident Communication. And don't forget to subscribe our channel. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye-bye and take care.